You know, they say there are two sides to every coin and two truths to every story. Now, how does this apply to real estate syndications? Stick around to find out. Let's do this. I'm Michael Blanc. I teach people how to become financially free with real estate by investing in apartment buildings. We post new videos every week, so be sure to subscribe so you don't miss a thing. Did you know that one of the most famous buildings in the United States, the Empire State Building, was purchased through a real estate syndication? That's right. It was the first of its kind, really. 3,000 people came together in the 1960s to invest in this historic property. That's pretty cool, right? Owning a stake in a piece of property that you normally wouldn't be able to afford on your own is one of the pros of investing in real estate syndication. But for every pro, there is a con. Today, I'm going to help you weigh the options when it comes to investing in real estate syndication. So I've been investing in real estate for a long time, but for the past, decade, I've been focused on multifamily real estate. As an operator or sponsor, you know, that's what we call ourselves, people who do deals and raise money from others. I know all the ins and outs of syndicated real estate deals. Trust me, there are a lot of benefits to investing in a real estate syndication, which is why I've dedicated my career to it as both an operator and an educator. Now, today, I want to share with you the cons of investing in a multifamily syndication. Before we get into the cons, though, let's quickly turn to some of the pros. All right, top of the list, above average returns. At a lower risk than other investment strategies, particularly when compared to the stock market. Now, there's a lot of ground to cover here on this particular pro aspect, especially as it relates to tax benefits. So I won't go all the details in this video, but I did write a special report about it that you can download on my website. Pro number two is that you know what you're getting versus a REIT or maybe a fund. With a multifamily syndication, you know the exact property and strategy the operator is taking to increase the profit on the property. I think this is a huge pro because I want to know what I'm investing in, right? If I'm investing in a fund, who knows what they're investing? I have no idea. I might be able to drive to it if I want. I can say I own a piece of this particular building. So knowing exactly who you're getting into, who's going to be running the property is a major pro. All right, pro number three is diversification of your investment portfolio. So you're only buying a small stake in the property, which leaves you money to invest in other properties or different investment vehicles altogether. An example of Empire State Building, many of those 3,000 investors invested only $10,000 and they own a stake in that iconic building. So what a lot of past investors do is they don't invest all of their net worth in a single property. They invest in multiple properties in a certain asset class that you like and then maybe in some other asset classes as well. Now, the last pro on my list is my favorite, mailbox money. Who doesn't love mailbox money? Investing in real estate syndication is one of the best forms of passive income because it actually generates income. Cash flow, which you don't get from the stock market at all. In truth, the most work you'll do up front is researching the opportunity and the operator and sponsor, and then most past investors continue investing with the same operator and sponsor year after year. And now for the cons list. You ready for the cons list? The first con of real estate syndication is that your investment money is frozen. Well, okay, it means it's no longer liquid, okay? It's tied up for the length of the deal, which is typically 5 to 7 years. Now, that's not really a bad thing when you consider the above average consistent compounding returns you're going to get, but it's definitely something to take into consideration if you've never done something like that and you're used to calling up your broker and selling stock. Another con is lack of control over the deal, right? Because you're investing as a limited partner. So the pro, of course, is that your investment and your exposure is limited to the amount of money you invest. As an active partner, as a general partner, you know, we have legal liability for the property. As a limited partner, you don't have that. So that's pretty cool. But in return to get that limited liability, limited exposure, is you also give up some control, which means that someone else, a sponsor, decides when to refinance, to sell, et cetera. So this is very important that you invest with an operator who knows, has a deep track record, and you know you can trust to make the right decisions. And some investors think, as a last con that I can think of here, is that some of the costs and the fees are hard to understand in a real estate syndication, which in reality is really kind of the result of choosing the wrong operator or sponsor to partner with who doesn't explain these things here. So it's very important that you as a passive investor put the time in to vet the right operator before jumping into a deal. Now, you don't need to have 5, 10, 15 operators. You need like 2, maximum 3, because each of these operators are going to have 2 or 3 or deals every single year. You don't need a lot. So once you do the upfront work to vet one of these operators, you can continue investing with them year after year. So if you want to get started in real estate syndications on your path to financial freedom, there are 2 things you should do right now. Number 1 is to continue educating yourself. It's the best thing you can do to make smart moves with your money. I have a resource center that you should check out. I'll put a link to it in the description. down or low. It's called Get Started with Passive Investing. Number two is start creating a relationship with potential deal sponsors so you can get to know them and how they do business. In fact, if you want to set up a call with us, our firm is called Nighthawk Equity. We'd love to have a chat with you. Head on over to our website, which is nighthawkequity.com. Click the join button, and then you can fill out a short form and set up a call with us. We'd love to discuss your investment goals and share what deals we're working on now that we might be able to share with you. So as you can see, there are far more pros and cons investing in real estate syndications. If you're still wondering how you can earn money with real estate investing, check out my video for four ways you can make money in real estate investing. I'm Michael Blanc. Catch you next time. Hey, and before you go, make sure you subscribe to my YouTube channel because we're putting stuff out every single week. Also, check out this special report just for you. It's what's the best investment, the stock market or real estate? It's going to blow your mind. And here's another video for you to check out.